done, son.
I think the last show I binge watched was season 2 of Ozark.
I think a terrifying animal would probably be something like an anglerfish or something. Imagine you're in the water and you just hear this screeching bitch, you know, in your ear with nothing but rows and rows of teeth.
10 million dollars.
I'm gonna say 50 bucks.
This had just recently happened to me. I was trying to play Call of Duty. I finally got the headset and everything. This kid starts cussing me out. And I'm like, so it was like a list of stuff. I almost broke my controller. You know, I threw the headset off. You're out there, kid, and I will find you. We're gonna listen to Dead and Done together, by the way.
I'd probably go with something that would make me, that I would find, you know, comfort in, because I'm about to eat the big one. Not KFC, I just want a bucket of fucking skins. I want that secret recipe skin, because I don't give a shit at that point about a heart attack. I want a big heaping pile of KFC skins as my husband. That's so disgusting.
Guilty pleasures, yacht rock, but classic rock.
What is yacht rock?
Yacht rock is like early 80s, like Doobie Brothers, Daryl Hall, Hall & Oates. It's guilty pleasure stuff, which, okay, you know, I grew up on, so.
The more you know.
We're in Thailand and they had these tanks of fish and you put your feet in there. And it's the weirdest feeling. It feels almost like pins and needles. And these fish eat all the dead skin off your feet. It's kind of weird. It's a weird sensation, but I recommend it. I'd say it's worth trying, yeah.
We've actually literally been underneath the stage and not known how to get to the stage before. Like,
yeah, that. Yeah. Hello Cleveland has definitely happened, yeah, to us. There's also these huge theaters in the Midwest where there will be a smaller theater on one side and then the bigger one. We're playing one side and we come out through the tunnel and up to the stage. No crowd, empty seats. Yeah. We're on the wrong side of the freaking theater. Hello Cleveland.
Will my daughter have a good life?
Damn, that cut deep, man. Wow. Man.
The lily.
Aww. Aww. That's sweet. I don't live by any mottos. I basically just try to make my dad proud of me. I spent many years not making him very proud, so now that he's passed away, I've decided that I'll spend the rest of my life making sure that wherever he is, he's proud of me.
Being healthy, I think, is it's just super important to me for her to have that. And she does CrossFit and Jiu-Jitsu with me. A healthier life is a happy life.
I think probably my fear of confrontation. It's kept me out of a lot of trouble, but probably got me into a lot of trouble too. I don't like conflict at all. I actually despise it. But I think because of that, I kept myself out of a bunch of potentially dangerous situations. But it's not one I'm particularly proud of. But my fear of conflict is something that is quite prominent as a personality trait.
Common sense, because common sense seems to be going out the window.
It already is, I think.
I think the biggest misconception, and I've had conversations with very intelligent people about this, where I've convinced them that we rode elephants to school, and we had lions in the backyard, and we used to wear loincloths. And when we got to...
Wait, you didn't?
No. Actually.
My kids, my two boys.
You don't own those, Johnny.
I possess them. I have an Elvis Presley autograph, and Elvis as a kid, that was like the first music for me, so I have an Elvis Presley autograph. It was a gift to me, I cherish.
The correct answer to that question is every single Steven Seagal movie.
Oh, yes! Dude! Steven Seagal in a musical is genius.
DeLoreans on time travel, forget about it.
Stay away.